time you see us take a picture of our feet, just know we are most likely at the airport or going on a trip. So at LaGuardia Airport, they have this beautiful water show, water and light show. At least I know where my taxpayer dollars are going. It is a beautiful show. We watched it. I had a lot of footage of it, but I had to shorten it for the sake of the video. But it was really beautiful. We are on our way to ATL. I have a lot of work to do, and I'm going to see family. So check out our video.
Jump on the coke folk head, y'all come to the city, get a feel for this L. And I wanna go home, I know you love what it tastes like. But it ain't too far, we had to live up in the trenches. Y'all went back to the birds when they got up on them late nights. Look, we really ran through these streets, we ain't never get a break.
We first arrived, we went to a place called Plates. That was honey, cornbread, which wasn't bad. Fried devil eggs, trash. Service, trash. Seth's ribeye, amazing. My crab cakes, amazing. If you haven't noticed already from my previous videos, I love to record the scenic route when I'm driving, when I'm walking. I love the view of trees and the road. So in my videos, you'll see a lot of that. This is me and my cousin turning up in the car, my little cousin Chantel. We had a good time. I always have a good time in ATL, but I'm always ready to go back home. It kind of like inspires me to be turned up when I get back home and, you know, put me back in that mind state that I need to get to what I gotta get to.
Queen of the South. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I be doing these interviews, they always ask me what's my hobbies outside of rap. Shitting on bitches. I'm the youngest and richest. These bitches know what's up with me. If we beefing, I got you. Won't put no shows in my city. Too picky with the kitty. He ain't hit me.
So we are in Atlanta and I have a meeting with a very special guest. It's so exciting to be able to travel, and I built the life that I always wanted. I wanted to be able to travel and go from place to place, meeting new people and just spreading as much love as I can. With that being said, no one's perfect. I still yell, I still cry, I still scream and get upset about things, but the journey that I'm on is so special, and it's even more special that I get to travel with this little one and, you know, do what needs to be done. So today we are at La Parrilla, I think it's called. It's a Mexican restaurant in Atlanta, and I'm meeting with someone very special. Her name is Jasmine Flowers. She is a media personality, and I just hopped in the DMs. When I talk about in my guide how you're going to meet people, how you're going to introduce yourself, if you have substance and you have worked hard to build the image that you want to have, and you present yourself in the most professional manner that you can, people are more prone to work with you. They see your pages professional, they see the connections that you've made, and they are able to understand, okay, maybe I can talk to this person because she has all this going on, she's done all of these things, and you know, maybe it's worth a try. So I hopped in her DMs and told her that I wanted to interview her, and she accepted my invitation. So we are here, we're gonna set up, we're gonna talk, we're gonna chat. We're going to find out some information if you're interested in becoming a media personality, how you can get started.
Hey guys, I wanted to let you all know about this talented hairstylist and business owner from Staten Island, New York, by the name of Miss Trinity. Her service menu and products are available on her website at www.trinityplacedesigns.com. Her hair products are for all genders as well as children. Products include her bestseller, Holy Hold Edge Control, shampoos and conditioners, styling mousse, detangling spray, and much more.
So we arrived to La Parrilla. We ordered chips, queso, salsa. Jasmine had a chicken fajita. We ordered lots of margaritas. I had a steak quesadilla. Seth had beef tacos. Look at him munching. We ordered more margaritas.
Hey, Kelsa.
Love the packaging too.
Thank you.
I'm a package girl, and trust me, we've been through it.
You know, when you first get them vendors.
Welcome back to From Self to Show with Trinity. We are in Atlanta at La Parrilla Mexican restaurant ordering margaritas. You know, I am a margarita, and today we have such a special guest. I'm gonna let her introduce herself, but we are so excited to have her, and we thank her for being with us today.
Hello, everybody. My name is Jasmine Flowers. I'm super excited to be here today. I'm a media personality. I have a radio show on WTT Radio with my co-host, Raheem Brazil. It's called The Platform Speak every Monday night from 7 to 9. I also just this year started with Media Girls Network. Super excited about that. Y'all should check out Jaleesa and all the amazing work and all the amazing women over there, too. And I also go to events, and I report on what I find from celebrity events, entrepreneurs, and everything that's happening around here in Atlanta. I'm super happy to be here today.
Yes, we're so happy to have you. So let's start from the very top. Yes. Where are you from? How'd you get started? I want to know that.
Okay, so I actually, I was born in Florida, but we're going to skip over there real quick because I've been in Atlanta since I was 2 years old.
Ooh.
So I consider ATL my home. It's where I'm from, it's where my roots are, southwest side of Atlanta. I actually just met, Killer Mike not too long ago, a couple of days ago, and he's from Atlanta. He's been one of my biggest inspirations. I actually grew up in the same community that I did, Adamsville.
Nice.
But I went to Clark Atlanta University.
Ooh.
Yes. Let me tell y'all, historically black college and university, Clark Atlanta University, and amazing background there. And then I went to Full Sail for my master's degree.
Okay, master. Okay, master. Y'all better get y'all degrees up. Stop playing with her.
Okay. And that's the entertainment business. So my whole life, professional life, and what I wanted as a kid has always been in communications, entertainment, and media.
Nice.
But my goal when I started out at Clark was to be, I wanted to be a film director and producer.
Okay.
And I still produce directly too. But I made a shift about 7 years ago to the front end of media. And I never
in front of the camera.
I never thought that I would do that. Didn't even think that I had, honestly, I didn't think I had what it took to be in front of the camera.
Now, okay, so let's pause. Mm-hmm. Is it because of how you look? Is it because you felt like, okay, maybe my image, my skin tone, yes, wouldn't be perceived well? Like,
yeah.
What was that?
I think it was a little bit of everything. I was just, like, young, when I was younger, I was just very insecure, and I was very shy. But, like, around the age of 24, I realized that I just wasn't living.
About your insecurity.
Oh yeah. So I was just shy and insecure and just, honestly, it was me. Like, just not thinking that I had what it
takes. Psyching yourself out.
Yeah.
A lot of people do that.
Yeah, but just, and that's all that it was. Like, it wasn't even anybody else. But at 24, I decided I wanted to live. I wanted to have a real life. And so I put myself out there even more. And then in 2016, was it 7 years ago now? I started the podcast.
Ooh,
and I started out of nowhere. I was like, I want to talk. And it was really because, honestly, it was because of a bad breakup.
Ooh.
And I felt like
see what y'all be doing to us? We got to start talking.
Okay.
Because
I felt like I had been, like, not living for my full potential, living towards
right.
my full potential.
And it's a huge difference.
Yeah. And so, So in 2016, started a podcast with two other women. It was called Even Exchange.
Ooh, and I like that name.
It's a dope name, right?
Ooh.
And so from that, I just went to one platform to the next building. But I tell people the second phase of my career started 2 years ago.
Ooh.
When I started, and it was the work that I'm doing now was started 2 years ago. Because honestly, like I said, I didn't know what I was doing when I first started the video.
Mm.
But 2 years ago, I started working for a woman named Kim. And her, she had a blog. I hear that girl. And I started writing for beauty. But she had something open up where she would send people out to do, like, entertainment pieces and stuff. And I was like, I said, I love beauty. I love makeup and hair and all nails and stuff. I was like, but I really love entertainment. And I was like, if you ever have anything open for entertainment, let me know.
Volunteer my time.
Yeah.
Let me tell you guys, volunteering is not always a negative thing. Sometimes you need to volunteer your time. And the money can come after. Stop looking at, ooh, they don't need to work for free. It's not that they want you to slave. They want to see your drive. They want to see what you're willing to do for this position.
Absolutely. Honestly, I started taking every opportunity she had, probably more than some of the other people.
Yep.
And I was like, if you have something, I'll do it.
Yep.
Sign me up, I'm ready, I'm willing to do it. So I really love the work that I was doing, going out meeting people. And I was like, I didn't even know being in media, doing press work like this was actually not as difficult as I thought it was going to be. And I didn't think it would be as rewarding as it is. And I felt like I have found my purpose and what I need to do. I was like, I love interviewing people. I love talking to people. And I love being a part of this media world. I still love producing, too. Like, that, like, all of it is a part of who I am.
Yeah. I feel like every little job, if you know a little bit about everything, it makes you go down
for sure
to the situation.
I wish we could say bitches.
It was your first, I guess, big event. Like, it really was like, okay, I energized with flowers. Which event made you feel like, okay, I'm starting to get up in here?
Okay, so this is the first time that it happened to me, but I guess it's customary in most people. I went to this Finding Happy premiere with B. Simone is in this show called Finding Happy. And this is about to be real small to people who do media, but they had a square cut out of my actual name on the floor. Mm. Like on a piece of paper saying where that was my spot to stand on. I had never seen that before. Mm. And that was like literally last year, and I was like, I remember looking at it like, I made it. Like I said, I know other press people are gonna be like, girl, please.
Yeah.
But for me, it was really like, oh wow, I had gotten this on my own because I had been working for other people. Mm-hmm. And doing media work for other people. Mm-hmm. So I was just like, this is really mine. Like, my name is on it. So it just made me feel even better about it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's like when you get your first badge, when you go to an event.
Yeah.
Like,
yes. Like, I was like, I did this on my own,
Yeah, have your own name up there.
Yeah. It was dope. I was really excited.
That means they know you. You're not just staff.
Right. Yeah, I still remember that moment.
I was happy about just being staff, shit.
Yeah.
Hair stylist.
Right. It just makes you feel good, like, you got it on your own. Like, you did the work to get in the room. And then once I got in the room, I was like, now I got my questions together. I'm asking all of these people who are a part of making this production work. I'm, like, asking them pertinent questions. I think T.C. Carson was there, who played Kyle on Living Single. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I grew up watching Living Single. So I'm like,
they're not that far away.
Right. And I'm like, he's literally an arm's length away from me, this man that I had watched on TV.
Did you speak to him?
Like, yes, I interviewed him.
Okay.
Yes, and I was like, oh my God, I really like, and I made him laugh too. And I was like, I remember Thursday night, like, and we should have never been watching this, by the way, because we were kids. But watching Living Single and like seeing Kyle before his next scene, and now here I am as a 30-plus-year-old woman having a conversation with somebody that I saw on TV growing up. Yeah, it's just like, wow. Yeah.
I love that. So let's get into, how do you feel about people who want to be in media? What do you feel about the fake media people as opposed to real people? What kind of advice do you have for getting into media?
Here's what I feel about fake. At some point, the truth will always come out. You don't need to do a bunch of digging. You don't need to do a bunch of like, I'm gonna call you out. It will just come out. If you stay focused on what your goal is, that's the only thing you need to be doing anyway. Like, so for me, I have run into people who have been kind of nasty to me. I have run into people who have, like, you know, asking them for opportunities and they just kind of toss me off. I don't even take it personally. I think you have to go into media and entertainment and know everybody is an opportunist, even you. And that's okay. It's okay. It's just the motivation behind it. Like, I'm not trying to kick nobody to get to the top. I'm going to get to the top.
Right.
Like, period. I'm going to get there. I know I'm going to get there. I've been able to get here, so I know I'm going to get to the top. I don't need to down anybody. My mama used to always be like, it's enough room in the playground for all the kids.
Ooh, I like that.
Like, it's enough room, so you don't have to do anything. You don't have to worry about the fake people. I just tell people, like, that's a distraction from what you need to do. In every industry, in whatever you do, wherever you go, it's going to always be fake people. That's the one thing you can count on.
Yeah.
Even, like, I'm pretty sure when you were in kindergarten, there was some fake-ass cheer in there.
Not the fake-ass
Some fake-ass cheer, and they were young.
Starting up early.
Yeah, so it's gonna be fake people everywhere. But you need to focus on what you need to focus on. You need to go, you know you have goals. That's all you need to worry about. Like I always tell people, the word no is never a thing unless you're talking about sex. But other than that, it's negotiable. Y'all need to remember that. No means no when it comes to sex. But anything else? Anything else? It's a no-ish. It's never cut free.
That could turn into free, yeah.
Yes. So, yeah, I just tell people, first things first, don't worry about the naysayers. Don't worry about the fake people. You do what you need to do, because that's the only thing you need to be focused on. And for the people who are trying to get in media...
Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you visit us at trinityplacedesigns.com. Back to the video.
One, work. Network. Connect with people. Stop being afraid to reach out to people. We live in the most, like, technology-friendly, communication-friendly era ever. There used to be a time where you literally could not touch a celebrity. Hitting a celebrity is literally an inbox away.
Yep.
Like finding out who their
people are. I always say it's a DM away.
Exactly. It's a DM away. Finding out their PR people. Mm-hmm. Like sometimes even, y'all, I'm going to tell y'all, even if you don't get confirmed from an outlet, if you know where it's going to be, why did you stay your ass at home? Mm-hmm. Take your ass down there. Go to the event anyway. Like, and then.
Now you're saying without a ticket, just pull up. Y'all hear that?
Pull up. Why are you not pulling up?
So now let's say I pull up to this location. I'm media. I got my camera.
Yeah. A lot of times in events, you might just blend in. Y'all, live. Live. Why y'all?
This is a Jesus Network meeting.
Uh-oh. Okay, let me change that a little bit.
This though.
Makeup instead of lying, make up a good reason that you can make believable.
Listen, some people say fake till you make it.
Yeah.
Do what I guess needs to be done.
Yes, do what needs to be done. What is 100% a fact is if you don't show up, you won't get it. What is an opportunity, maybe if you show up and you blend in, you might get that opportunity. But for sure, if you stay at home, you won't. So I tell people, look, if you see somebody doing something that you want to do, ask them how they're doing it.
I agree with that.
And also keep in mind, y'all, it's a lot of people who charge y'all for media lists. It's a lot of people who will charge you for a
I've been
contract.
Trying to get on a few media lists. You hoes been hating. Okay. I'm going to get there, though.
And I will tell people how to do it. Look at these companies. Look at, in your city, just go through a list of entertainment PR companies. Ooh. Email them and ask them to put you on their PR list. Like, y'all, I always tell people, I am not a gatekeeper.
That is a golden tip right there. Shit, I'm about to do that.
Yes, I am not a gatekeeper. I will never hang on to any information. It's not mine to keep. Again, go to your city, whatever city you're in, look up the top entertainment PR firms. And I'm talking about ones that actually do, like, they do the press for TV, movies, things like that. Ask them to be added to the press list, but send them examples of some work that you've done. Like, even if it was something that you just went to, send it. Or just tell people, like, I'm really trying to get involved. Would you please allow me? Y'all, don't be afraid of asking questions. Like, that's one of the best things that you can do. Get to know publicists. You need to know publicists. You need to know, like, these publicists who have the access to their clients. And just tell them, like, I want to interview for such and such. Okay, so maybe you can't get the drink right now, okay? Their publicists may be like, get out of here. Exactly. They may tell you to get out of there. That's okay, too.
So I have a question. Because I think that people that don't know about media and PR, what is the difference? Does everybody need PR? Does everybody need public relations? Yeah. Does media, like, how does it all work together?
Public relations is key to media. Public relations is media. Media is PR. So they're all working together. Like, if you talk to a publicist, the publicist is the person that connects all of these parts together. So whatever their client needs, an individual client or a company, they connect all the parts of what that person or company may need. So this is why I say get to know the publicists, because they are the well-connected individuals that you need to know. For instance, I mean, honestly, that's part of when I talked about being an opportunist before. Like, people hate that word. I love the word opportunist because I know my motivation behind being an opportunist. I'm not going to step on anybody's back, but I do want an opportunity. Yeah. You doggone right, I need the opportunity.
You just
want to
make sure you always make yourself available.
Exactly. So that's one of the reasons why I joined Media Girl. It's an Media Girls Network. It's an opportunity to link with people who are doing the exact same thing that I'm doing, but on a higher scale.
So now, if somebody was interested in that, how do they apply? What would be the reason? Like, what's the criteria to join the Media Girls Network and start up? Like, what do they do?
So Media Girls Network has a recruitment opportunity for women too. So I would say the best bet is to reach out to Media Girls Network, the inbox, and hit up Jaleesa is the fearless leader over the whole thing. Jaleesa Raquel. She's a publicist. She also goes out to events. She has tons of clients. Jaleesa is super well connected. There's not a person in Atlanta who doesn't know Jaleesa. So you need to get to know her too if you're trying to do stuff like this. One of the easiest human beings to talk to about this too. So send her a message on Media Girls Network if that's something that you're trying to do,
okay,
and ask her how you can get involved. And then when you get the opportunity, show the hell out. Like, and that's what I tell people too. There are opportunities to grow, but you need to make it known that you want the opportunity.
Yeah.
Don't get into like an organization like Media Girls and then don't do anything.
Yeah.
Like, and then too,
I
y'all
can't make it.
Yeah.
I'm not around. I'm on vacation.
And then like, y'all, speak up. Like, speak up and say, here's an issue that I see, or here's something that I want to do. Speak up, take the initiative.
Yeah.
You know, I tell people, you have to make it known that you want to do something. So yeah, that's what I tell women to do.
That's weird.
Yeah.
I'm so excited. Because I think that people will just gravitate towards the point of being around these people and being in the room. And it's great to be in the room, but you want to make a stance. Like, I want to be known for something. I want a street named after me. I want a corner. You know, that's this Trinity Place.
Yes.
Even though there's a street in New York already named Trinity Place. I want one in Staten Island that, like, I did something to help the community. And it's from the heart. Like, you gotta have some type of passion from the heart. Some people just have great talent, but they have no passion, no personality,
nothing
or anything
behind
it. And that doesn't last long.
Absolutely.
You have great talent, but nobody wants to hang out with you. You have to have a little bit of everything to be so well-rounded that people don't mind giving you an opportunity. You're the first one to pop up in their mind.
Likeability goes a long way.
Yeah.
Being likable, but also, of course, being yourself. You don't want to be a pushover because people don't respect pushovers either. But you want to be firm in who you are so that people don't have an opportunity to go in there and try to tell you who you need to be.
Yeah.
You don't want to do that either. But yes, be likable. Be present. Be in the moment. And be prepared.
Yeah. They nobody wants to do work. They're like, they're in school. They don't want to do work. Like, even for my interviews or just writing up stuff, you want to come out a certain way so people are like, okay, she took the time
absolutely
out to send this and do that. Like, it's important. But some people feel like, nah, I'm going to just text them.
Yeah.
And, you know, it goes a long way.
Absolutely.
So what is your, like, ultimate goal through media? Like, what is your top thing that you want to achieve if you haven't already?
Okay. So my ultimate goal is to be producing the hottest TV, reality, and film.
Ooh.
That people have ever seen. Yes.
That's so you ain't called Mona Scott yet?
Well,
you say, yeah, is she? She's out here?
Off the record, yeah. I think Mona Scott is out here, I think so. But I thought she
came York up in, and she's an older girl.
Yeah.
Beautiful older girl, but she's not a youngin'.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
She's out here.
She's been doing
in
it
the
for
bag
a while, yeah.
She's getting the bag.
Yeah, but that, and also, like, my goal too is to continue on the trajectory that I'm on and making sure that I get some of the world's top entrepreneurs, celebrities, culture shifters and movers and have like authentic conversations with them about their path in life and also where they're projecting their futures to go.
Nice.
Yeah, hosting maybe some TV shows. So
ooh, put that out there.
Yes.
Jasmine Flowers is putting out her public application.
Yeah.
I definitely want to do that. Have you been to the Grammy? Not yet. I told myself next year is the year that I'm gonna go to like the big award shows. So nice. I'm mapping out my goals for that too. So I'm dying to go there. Yeah, that's great. Yeah, so now this is like questions about the red carpet. When you're on the red carpet, are you nervous to be like, hey, I'm Jasmine, like, how do you get their attention? Because I feel like they just went to 20 other people.
Yeah.
What's going to make you stand out that they want to talk to you?
So much. You know what? I will say this. I am a gentle giant. Yeah. I'm a plus size girl, obviously, but I'm very
tall.
Okay,
shout out to the big girl.
Okay, shout out to the big girl. Hey. But I'm also 6 feet tall. Okay. I'm 6 feet tall, so I understand that when I have.
Are you really?
I'm tall, yeah.
Damn, I didn't and think I, that little.
And I kind of use my height, too. I know, one, I tower over everybody. So I know, one, I'm going to be seen anyway. Because I'm like, everybody's here, and I'm up here. Not on like a, I'm better than everybody, but literally, height-wise, I'm taller than almost everybody who's there. And sometimes I just look and wait my turn, or sometimes I'll just be like, well, I'm ready to go first. You cannot be afraid to just get up there and get the mic in somebody's face, or whatever you need to do. And honestly, like, when I first started, even, I just recently got a mic, too. Like, I went out with my camera phone, and I tell people sometimes.
So now you have a mic that plays Jasmine Flowers on?
I don't even have that yet. No.
Oh, just the mic?
Yeah. I got a mic now.
Connected to your phone, like one of them.
Yeah. Yeah. I have a camera too, but I don't have a tripod yet. But I tell people, let me tell y'all, when you go out to these events, make you some friends. I have a group of amazing friends that we typically go to events together. Sometimes I'm on my own. When I first started, I was on my own. But my friends and I really look out for each other. When we know the other one wants to interview, I'm going to hold your camera while you get this. Yeah. Like, we do that for each other. And this is why I said, when people say, I don't need anybody, well, I don't know how far you're going to get with that attitude.
Yeah, no, you
because
need someone.
It is.
It's just we put the wrong people in that place.
Exactly. Don't be afraid of just making friends, even if it's just industry friends. I've been lucky enough to meet people in this industry who are my friends inside and outside of the industry. So, like, don't. I just tell people, you may not have everything that you need. The only thing you need is confidence when you step on that red carpet. Like, there are going to be tons of people.
I've been on, like, events that I knew the people who were doing it, and it was a red carpet, but, like, the red carpet?
Yeah.
That's different.
You know what? And it's, I tell people, if you let that intimidate you, you messed up from the start. You already, the hard part I tell everybody is you got into the room. That's the difficult part because you're not going to have access to every room you want to get in.
Yeah.
I'm dying to get to Beyonce. Of course, everybody is. I know right now I don't have access to Beyonce. But that's not
to
say
like
one day
I won't. That's such a hard one, like going to Rock Nation. Like, how the hell do people that are not those people get to Rock Nation?
That's one of my goals.
That's the time I don't even see no advertisements.
Yeah, but that's one of my goals. But that's why I tell people, networking, connecting with people, that's how you get into these rooms. 2 years ago, I never would have thought I would have gotten into it. Well, I did Revolt. I did the...
I was Revolt. I heard that they treat people well at Revolt.
Revolt is awesome. And it's black excellence all around. Whatever your black
excellence is. So now Revolt is ran by Diddy or does he work with someone else?
Diddy works with a couple of people to make things. So I'm going to be honest. I used to think that Diddy was anti-black, right? Like, I used to see him. Like, I mean, we all saw Making the Band when he made those kids walks in New York. I thought that was the lamest thing. You
y'all can't get over that cheesecake.
Yeah. I remember at the time thinking that was so lame to make people who want to do music fool themselves to you by walking across a bridge. It had nothing to do with music.
Yeah.
And then, like, along the years, you would hear these stories about how Diddy has, like, wanted somebody's money or other things too. So I held the same idea about Diddy that almost everybody else does. But Diddy is actively working to make sure that black people have a stance. Like, I've been at about 3 different events, I believe, with Diddy, or not with him, he wasn't there, but like things that he has started where Diddy is literally focused on black excellence. Revolt is a part of that. Whether you are a Democrat, Republican, whatever, wherever you lie politically, wherever you lie in the world, there's a place for you at Revolt. Like, he has so many excellent black people who are a part of that. I went to this event in November. It was called Empower, which is him literally looking at black entrepreneurs in the e-commerce space and making sure that their products get sold. Like, and I was like,
hey, Diddy.
Exactly. Like, Diddy is really, really doing things for people. And then one of the studios for Revolt is right here in Atlanta, in Black Atlanta. So, yeah. And, like, I believe her name is Khadija. She is the CEO of Black Woman of Empower. And then I know his name, so I cannot believe his name is escaping me right now, but over Revolt.
And he's 20 minutes back. Sorry. It'll tell you if it stops recording. It's still going? Okay. How many more minutes? Okay, so stop it and start it over. No, just press the button. Now start it over, sir. Okay, so back to Diddy. No, it's all right, girl. Let me get a bite.
Crunch and lunch.
Okay. But Diddy is really, like, he's really doing his thing to really push black people into spaces that black people have never seen before. And I think that it's worth it to people to really lean into all the things that he's doing, particularly for, it's literally for black people. Like, even with, I interviewed this guy that I had been listening to for years, who was actually one of the ones who made me want to be in the podcasting space. His name is Justin Ross.
Okay.
And he's on a podcast, The Friend Zone, with Asante and Friends. And I love that podcast. I started listening to it before I started my podcast. And I had always wanted to talk to Justin Ross. I got that opportunity to interview Justin Ross. And he is the second season host of Bet on Black, which is on BET, which is kind of like Shark Tank. This is particularly for black people. And Target is a part of that. They aren't taking a stake in nobody's black company. They're only making sure that their products get out there. So Diddy is literally helping out black entrepreneurs.
Yeah, but it gets overshadowed by, like, the negative.
Yeah, by the things that he's done. I'm just like, he's doing a lot of work. You know, he's doing.
And nobody's perfect. Like, you might see me do something one day. You be like, oh, yeah, she was all there talking about some products. But she's over here doing it. We're all humans.
Exactly.
We're going to make mistakes and do things that don't make sense to you.
Exactly. And the thing is, it doesn't have to make sense to everybody, but it just has to translate best for you.
Yeah.
So I'm excited about that. Yes.
So how can people contact you? What's the best way to get through to you? How can they work with you? I think you told us about how they can get with Media Girls Out Network. What up? Like, what up?
So y'all can always watch my listen to my radio show on WTT Radio and also iHeart Radio. It's every Monday night. It's every Monday night from 7 to 9 p.m. with the fantastic Raheem Brazil. The platform speaks, like I said, on WTT Radio. We can also be heard on iHeart. You can also follow me on my social media, Jasmine Flowers, JASMYNEFLOWERS.
Is that
really
your last name?
Beautiful.
Everybody
I used to know a guy named Tyler. I wonder if he's your cousin. Right, cut that.
Okay. Everybody asks me, like, is this my real name? I'm like,
Trinity, because my first name is Leona, but my last name is Trinity.
So So but y'all can hit me up across social media platforms, Jasmine Flowers, JASMYNEFLOWERS. And email me, firstnamelastname@gmail.com. So let's connect.
We want to thank Jasmine so much for sitting down with us. We done ate, we done drank, we done chill, we in Atlanta. And we are so excited. Make sure you check her out, check out her media that she's putting out there. And follow her too. There's no easy way to get in. You have to put in some work. And until next time, this is from Self to Self.
I want to take this time to thank Jasmine so much. I had an amazing time with you. A photo shoot with at the Cam Killer, Raphael. He was amazing, so professional, made me so comfortable because I felt bloated. I had a breakout. Anything that could go wrong when you're having a photo shoot happens, but he did an amazing job, and I can't wait to show you all. I've been drinking more alcohol for the past 5 days. Did you check on me? Now did you look for me? I walked in the room, eyes are red, and I don't smoke banga. Did you check on me? Did you check on me? Now did you notice me?
In bed, but my mind still wandering, overthinking, but I'd rather be sleeping. Grab a drink, I need escape now. 247, I be in this state now, but I can no longer depend on it.
So I'm finally back home now, and I had a long day. As you can see, is my hair. My hair was under my wig. I will insert some of the pictures from the shoot, but I'll probably wash my hair tomorrow when I'm in the shower. I gotta take this makeup off, and I started breaking out right before the shoot.
My lips are Livy Collection. My outfit, this wasn't part of the shoot, but my shirt is from Shein. A lot of people have a problem with Shein or Shein or whatever the brand is, but a lot of the clothes that I have from there, people ask me about, are from Shein. But I am winding down. Seth has homework to do, so I will start editing my videos very soon. Talk to you later.
I hope all of you are enjoying the video, but I would like you to please pray for my baby cousin. It was her 1 year death anniversary, and I want her to rest in paradise. Hope she's checking on my sister and all the family members that we lost. She was amazing. Lash Tech. You can check out her page at AMG Beauty Glam. She's beautiful. It was a sad time, but you know, I had to be there to support my family. I love you, Sadie, so much.
So we visited the La Novo Maquis, which means the new underbush. I'm not sure the exact translation, but we had Suya. We bodied that. It was amazing, unbelievable. Then we also had kasawali and rice. We had pounded yam and kasawali, pounded yam and egusi. We had dibi and plantain. Yeah, we turned up. We definitely turned up on this menu for sure. And baby girl Serenity, she knows how to turn up on a plate of food for sure. I had such an amazing time. I hope you enjoyed this video. And you know, until next time, thank you for watching. We're going back home now.
Also shows with Trinity.